Do I have some kind of silly remark for this video? Oh yeah, it's a computer mess room. Oh, I'm sorry, it's the garage. Yeah, this is not my mess, but still called the computer mess room for a reason. Hello viewers, what you're looking at here is what I call the computer mess room, which is essentially a culmination of all my computers and my mother's junk. Can you tell? So, we're mainly going to be taking a look today at my computers that I own, and I'll try to do the best that I can with explaining them. Now, the reason why I'm using the GoPro is because I don't necessarily need to worry about image quality per se, as more along the lines of needing, you know, something that's different than my iPhone for recording. That, and it gives me a really good shot of all this stuff on the shelf here. In fact, let me throw super wide on this just as a joke. We'll see if this actually looks any sillier with super wide on. There you can see. Nice. Getting junk out of the way, let's go ahead and get started here. So, we're going to go ahead and probably work our way from the top shelf over and just kind of do everything cascading order, although we'll see. There's some more systems inside, and there's some ones that I won't be showing on the video, but I'll be talking about those as they go and whatnot. So first thing, we have a Gateway LX6810-01, this black system here. This one is a 2.33 GHz Intel Core 2 Quad. I don't think it's got any RAM in it right now, and the reason why I'm not using this system over my HP XW6600 is because, of course, this thing, you know, it looks nice and whatnot, but it's got some issues. For example, one of these hot swap SATA headers is bad, so I can't exactly use it for that sort of purpose, even though it would be nice. The only reason why I'm hanging on to it, though, is because it's a Core 2 Quad system. This is the only one I own, and so, you know, for that reason, I'm keeping it. Although, technically speaking, I could get a faster Core 2 Quad system, but that'll come another day when the prices on those, when the prices on Core 2 Quad start to turn Core 2 Duo prices or something like that. These two white box gateways are both E3600s. Obviously the one right there with the Windows XP and Pentium 4 stickers on it is the one made 5 days after Windows XP's launch. So obviously you can tell it's designed for Microsoft Windows XP. The other one's slightly newer. It's got a slightly faster Pentium 4 CPU in it. I don't know if it still works compared to the other one, which I know it does. As a matter of fact, actually I'm looking at this, you can tell, and probably not on camera, but I can certainly tell that this faceplate is slightly yellowed comparative to this one, so maybe I might have to toss some RetroBrite onto the front panel of this computer. Fortunately, it's easy to take off because that's separated from the front panel, and this could probably just be a disconnected sort of thing. That or it stays with the case and it just, you know, whatnot. So we'll see how that ends up working out in my favor. And maybe these systems will actually... I thought about wanting to just combine the parts from both of these systems to make one good system, but then again I want to represent how Windows XP would have came when it was launched on this system by keeping the slower CPU in it, so I did that for a reason. The other one's just basically a parts unit at this point, so who knows, we'll see if I end up keeping it in the future. Going on down the line, we have this particular custom build. This is a 2002 custom build, not mine of course. Well, I bought it, but it wasn't mine that I built, because obviously I couldn't build computers in 2002. This one is an AMD Socket A system. This is running a 1.3 GHz AMD Duron computer, or CPU, sorry. I think it's got a quarter gig of DDR400 memory in it, and it has a gigabyte dual BIOS motherboard on it, which is actually kind of neat considering when dual BIOS was just becoming a thing back in 2002 on motherboards that actually featured that. This one does work. It runs Windows 2000. I just don't have a use for it. I think the graphics card is a GeForce 4MX400 that came out of that HP Pavilion down there, which we'll get to. I'm thinking I'm going to part this system out, honestly speaking, and probably keep the motherboard and swap it into this one's case, although I could probably flip-flop them around. I don't know. We'll see. I only really need one good Socket A system, and these two are Socket A, So who knows, maybe I can figure something out with that. But this system does in fact work, and it does have the newer motherboard on it, but it's only an AMD Duron versus this one's Athlon, but this one's a 900 megahertz Athlon, so I guess they're even. I don't know, I'll have to compare benchmark scores. Get some old benchmarks going on these old Socket A systems on Windows 2000 to see if we can actually get them to work and actually give me some decent numbers. Right here, this little tiny system is a Dell Optiplex 755 ultra small form factor, which I bought off eBay for like, I think it was like 50 or 60 bucks when I bought it off eBay, with the power supply and a 160 gig hard drive, as well as 2 gigs of RAM and a 2.66 gigahertz Intel Core 2 Duo, as well as the D-Bay DVD burner drive, which was actually kind of nice to find. Now this system does work, although being that this is an Optiplex 755, it is based on the Intel GMA 950 integrated graphics, so it's not too particularly useful anymore on Windows 10, which this does have a license for, but unfortunately Windows 10 in the creators update runs pretty poorly on this system, as it's got some weird graphical glitching issues that it's been having on all Intel GMA 950 based systems. Sure, yes, I could run Windows 7 on the system just fine, or 8.1 for that matter, but whatever. I might actually bring this back down and actually put it back in as being a media center PC, but we'll see, because I might have something else in mind for that later on down the line that'll actually run Windows 10 decently. Although this one is an energy efficient system, so we'll see. I don't know. I'm currently using my PlayStation 4 as my little media center something, but all I really need it for is just watching YouTube and whatnot, so I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Don't necessarily need another computer running in my room anyway. Right next to it is another Dell. This is an Optiplex GX110 from 2000. And this one's fairly interesting, as it's got the humorous writing on the outside as well as the inside. I know I did a pretty poor job at making this computer into a video. I still need to make a part two to the video to kind of tell you guys how the system's doing. It's still around. I don't have any other Pentium 3 systems. That's the only reason why I've kept this thing. It works just fine. I just don't have a use for this particular one, because it's just so big and bulky, and it's only an 800 megahertz Pentium 3 socket 370. So I don't know. So here's a little bit of an older system here. This is a 1998 Compaq Prosigna PD1000. These are otherwise known as Compaq Desk Pro EP or SB systems, considering they use the same motherboard, which is weird because there's a Compaq Desk Pro EN sitting right next to it. Although that's the Pentium 2 version, so it's kind of neat. Anyway, this Prosigna has a 400 megahertz Intel Pentium 2. I don't know how much memory is in it. I want to say 256 meg. I could be wrong, though. It's kind of missing optical drive stuff and missing the blinking plate now. I pretty well mutilated this system ever since I got it way back in 2012. So, needless to say, yeah. I have no idea what OS it's running. It's probably still running that Windows Vista install I put on there, knowing my luck. Either that or it's running Windows 98. I don't know what I put back on the thing. We'll have to see. I don't know if I want to pull it down at some point right now, because I don't really need a Pentium 2 out. Of course, this ginormous Pentium 2 system is my $5 Compaq Desk Pro EN from 1998 or 1999, one of the two. This is the full tower Compaq Desk Pro EN Pentium 2. This particular one, I think, has a 350 megahertz Pentium 2. I'm trying to get my feet in here, so I'm moving around a little bit. But yeah, 350 megahertz Pentium 2. I think it's got 128 megs of RAM in it, and it's got its original hard drive, if I want to make the prediction. I don't remember. Anyway, this is running Windows Millennium Edition pretty well, actually. It runs Windows ME pretty darn well. And I want to say the... what the heck were the graphics on this thing? I think they were like ATI Rage 3D Turbo something graphics. I don't remember. They're AGP 2X graphics with that weird compact style of graphics card bracket. So this system might get another video. I'm not entirely sure. We'll see what I have for uses for it. This particular one right here, which of course is spray painted with my lovely spray painting skills, this is a custom build that I got from school for free, and I'm honestly thinking I'm going to junk it because I have no use for it. It's yet another Pentium 4 that I don't use. I'm obviously going to probably save the floppy drive. I'm going to save my precious 60 gig hard drive that I tossed in there. Might save the motherboard, although I'm not entirely sure. It is a Intel 845G custom motherboard, regular motherboard, 845G. So it's got USB 2.0 support, so maybe I'll find some use for it, but as it sits, like, no. There's my Compaq Presario 6708, which is a Pentium 200 megahertz with 32 megs of RAM, and its original 7.5 gig hard drive running Windows 95A. VMM32.vxd ended up mixing itself up again, so now it won't boot, but I'll look into this another day because, of course, I'm busy with school. Don't worry, we'll probably make some more videos on this system. We'll see what ends up happening. I don't know for sure. Moving on, we have my most reliable Pentium 4 system that I've ever owned in my lifetime. This is an HP Pavilion A250N from 2003. This features a 2.6 gigahertz Hyperthread Pentium 4 Northwood CPU. This has 2 gigs of DDR400 memory. I think it's got an 80 gig hard drive in it right now. It came with a 120 when it was new, but it was one of them Samsung spin points that was kind of slow. So I put in an 80 gig that was much faster. And this thing's actually a pretty decent little system. I also upgraded the graphics, so the old GPU ended up in that custom build right there, that AMD Duron one. And this got an AGP 8X GeForce FX5200 256 meg card. And I like this system a lot because it's got not only a floppy drive, but also a card reader, as well as front-mounted FireWire and USB 2.0, as well as front-mounted line-in microphone and headphone jacks. So this thing is a pretty versatile little system. It's going to suck when Windows 7 goes out of support because that's what it's running, because this thing is extremely useful. Although I'm debating whether or not I want to keep Windows 7 on this system because it's probably not the greatest to run on a Northwood Pentium 4. It does work, but it's not the fastest, so I'm debating whether or not I want to put Windows XP back on it. But all things considered, though, since it runs Windows 7 pretty well, I might leave it on there just because it gives me newer software support, including newer web browser. So it does come in handy, but yeah. Here is the prolific Packard Bell Legend 108 CD Supreme from 1995 that got Windows XP installed on it. In fact, it's actually still running Windows XP, which is kind of funny. This is a 75 megahertz Pentium processor with 80 megs of RAM, and I think it's got two hard drives in it. It's got the original 1.6 gig hard drive, as well as a 4 or a 6 gig edition 8-speed CD-ROM drive, because the original 4-speed died, apparently. Floppy drive. It's got the onboard Cirrus Logic graphics. So this system got pretty popular, I guess, on my channel for running Windows XP on a 75 megahertz Pentium, because I made the joke saying that Billy Corr every April Fool's Day tries to put Windows XP on his Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT. But I actually installed Windows XP on the system and it actually worked, which I was pleasantly surprised to see. Probably because it's got 80 megs of RAM. And I do have a plan of wanting to web browse on the system because it does have a network card in it now. I actually put one in, so maybe we'll try that. I don't know. But definitely, it's probably going to get put back on Windows 95 version 2.5, because I think that's the one disk I have, because I want to have a patched version of Windows 95 that's actually up to date. So we'll see about that. But definitely expect a video of me web browsing on a 75 megahertz Pentium here in the future, because that'll be very entertaining to watch. I know my shadow is in the way, but what we have here is a HP Pavilion 6735 from 2000. And over here we have a Pavilion 6630. I'm putting these two together because they're identical machines, essentially. The only difference is that this one has an older Celeron CPU versus this one. And this one's more complete and original compared to this one. This was a freebie at a yard sale. I literally just scooped this thing up for free. It came running Windows ME, and it was looked like it would have been owned by a senior citizen because it had a bunch of games on it and a weird Windows layout, so I just reinstalled Windows. Although I'm going to probably fix this thing back up to be a simple Windows 98 SE system. Probably going to be the same thing for this one, but I might just reinstall Windows ME. It's what it's running right now, but I don't have all the software installed on it. It came with some really cool software called, what the hell was it? Trellix web software, which would allow you to create basic websites. I don't know if they can still download that or if it was on CD, but it'd be really cool to actually test that out on the system and see if we can actually still make like web pages or something. I don't know. But this one's a 500 megahertz Celeron. I think it's got 128 megs of RAM in it. It could have 64. I don't know. This one I definitely know for sure is a 633 megahertz Celeron with 64 megs of RAM because I've not upgraded it. And, believe me, Windows Millennium Edition runs like a pile of smash on this system with 64 megs of memory. So I'll probably bump it up to 128, but I might just reinstall Windows 98 and leave it at 64 megs because Windows 98 doesn't mind that too much. but we'll see about that. Here is the Sony Vaio PCV RX755 that I made a video on. I still have not replaced the CPU cooler on it, but really that's the least of my worries. Apparently it's developed some kind of a scratch right there. That's kind of interesting. Anyway, I just put this out here just because I didn't have any place to put it. Now this one here, like I was briefly mentioning when I was mentioning this system up there, these are both Socket A AMD systems. This one's a 900 megahertz AMD Athlon. I think it's got, I probably upgraded to 512 megs of memory. It came with me with 256, and it actually came with a 120 gig IDE hard drive, which was nice. So yeah, but it was running the original owner's install of Windows XP, which I hope to cover an old version of Safari, which is actually still on it. It's kind of neat. This was a freebie as well, and the only reason why I accepted it because it has a 250 meg zip drive in it, which is really nice because I actually do have some 250 meg zip disks, which I need to, you know, make sure that they're wiped and everything, and could be useful for transferring data to and from some older computers if I get a USB external zip drive or parallel port zip drive or something like that. So, a very nice addition to the collection. Here's a computer that I've not mentioned on my channel ever, and I hope to maybe at some point. This is a Compaq Presario 5441, probably from 1998. It's one of those value-oriented 5000 series Presario systems, very similar to the 6000 series of HP systems, although I do think that the Compaq is more appealing, although definitely you could see where the expansion capabilities are on the Compaq, being that you get double the expansion in terms of the 5.25 and 3.5 inch bays versus the Pavilion 6000 series. Although there were different series of Pavilion models back in the late 90s that you could have picked from, with which you could have gotten a bigger case, which could allow you to have the same expansion capabilities as these Presarios. But of course, what do I know, right? Anyway, this is an AMD K6 system running at 475 megahertz. I don't know how much memory is in it. It does have its original 4.3 gig Seagate hard drive in it. I think it's a 4.3 gig. Could be wrong. Anyway, this thing, I don't know what OS it's running. I need to put Windows 98 back on it if it's not already running Windows 98. I think I reinstalled it, but I could be wrong. Either way, it's a pretty grungy little system. I need to clean it, but not in this sort of condition where I'm storing all these things, so there's no point in cleaning them because they're just going to get dusty and dirty again. So I'm hoping to remedy a shelving situation. We'll see, because my shed over on the other side of this garage, my mom keeps wanting to get me to build shelves, so I don't know. I'd rather have metal shelves, but she keeps trying to get me to, you know, make wood shelves, and metal shelves are honestly a lot cheaper. So yeah, I don't know, she just wants her shelving back so she can try to store some of the stuff that she never uses. I don't know. We'll see. That's an ongoing thing. Right here we have a few Dells. I put them together because they're all Dells. Here we have my desktop model Optiplex GX240, which I picked up at a pre-auction yard sale. Same thing with that e-machine over there. This is a 2 gigahertz Pentium 4 with 512 megs of RAM and the original capacity hard drive, but not original to the system, 20 gig hard drive. Right next to it we have a Dell Dimension 2400. This is a 2.8 gigahertz non-hyperthreading Pentium 4 with 2 gigs of RAM and an 80 gig hard drive, the original to the computer, as a matter of fact. This is a trash pick system, just like the Optiplex GX260 that sits next to. This one's currently running Linux Lite 3.6. I'm hoping to do a video on that OS because it runs super fantastic on a Pentium 4. I'm honestly surprised by how well it runs. But another video for another day. The GX260 is a 2.4 gigahertz Pentium 4. I think it's also got 2 gigs of RAM. And just barely running 2 gigs of RAM. It's about at that limit of age to memory capacity. Anyway, this thing is not got an OS on it. Here we have the Dell Dimension E310, which I put in my New Year's Special 2017 video. It's running Windows 7 now, instead of running Windows Vista, because it didn't run very well. But I'm probably going to format the hard drive and reinstall Windows XP on the system, we'll see. I do have a disk for Media Center Edition 2005 with Update Rollup 2 from Dell, so I might actually put that on the system and see if it works. Although, I'm debating whether or not I'm actually going to keep this system now that I have a newer Dimension E510, which you'll soon see in the next, I guess, scene, I guess. I don't know. Right next to that is an eMachine EL1300G, little small form factor system. I love these little things. They're really nice little systems, although this one's slightly older than the one I used to have, which was in a black case, versus this one, which has yellowed quite a bit. Instead of being white, it's now cream color, or off cream, I guess you could say. It's kind of like an really kind of going beige now. It is an AMD Athlon 64 of some description. I think it was like 2650E running at 1.6 gigahertz. It has an onboard NVIDIA Enforce chipset of some kind. So I think it's got like the GeForce 6100 series video in it. I'm not entirely sure about that. I think this has a gig of RAM, although I might have upgraded it to 2 gigs. And it's running Windows XP Home Edition Service Pack 3 out the box. So this is one of those last generation nettops that you could have bought back when Windows Vista was getting its prolificency, or in the prolificency period. The system's really nice though, because it's got 4 USB ports on the front as well as your card reader. Well, actually no, I take that back, 5 USB ports on the front, which is just ridiculous. I'm pretty sure the system can run Windows 10 just fine, although it's got its original install of XP, so that's what's running and what it's probably going to run for the rest of its life unless the hard drive dies. And finally, next to that, we have the HP Pavilion A6500F from 2008. I upgraded this system from its Pentium dual-core E2220 to a Core 2 Duo E8600, the Wolfdale Core 2 Duo. And this thing has 4 gigs of RAM, it has a 500 gig hard drive, and GeForce 7100 graphics instead of what these things usually come with, which is 6150 SE graphics. This one has the 7100, so it's a slightly newer, more beefy system comparative to the other one I used to have, which was an A6803W, which had the 6150 SE graphics. So this one's a bit more powerful despite being a little older, even though they use the same exact freaking case. Anyway, this system runs Windows 10 Home 64-bit just fine. I just have it out here because I don't have the room for it, but it definitely does get used. This is a nice computer, and trust me, the CPU was not cheap. So, yeah. Wrapping things up pretty quickly, we have the CRT to the Compaq Presario 6708. This is a Compaq Presario 1525 15-inch display, or it might be actually a 13-inch. I'm not entirely sure how big the CRT is compared to the iMac here. Anyway, probably has a 15-inch CRT, but the viewable area is a lot smaller compared to the iMac. Anyway, not much to say on that. Here we have my iMac DV2000 model. This is the 400 megahertz iMac DV, not the DV Plus. So this thing was not the one equipped with the DVD drive. It does not have the larger 20 gig hard drive, I think it was. Anyway, this does have FireWire ports on it, and it has its original 10 gig Seagate hard drive. The CD-ROM drive needs to be replaced. This is the one that came in indigo, and I think there was one more color. I don't remember for sure. Might have been, wasn't Sage, because Sage was on the DV Plus. I don't remember. Anyway, this is the iMac DV2000, the non-DV Plus model. This is just a straight DV. Here we have my HP Pavilion A1477C from 2006. This is an AMD Athlon 64X2 based system running Windows XP Media Center 2005 with unofficial Service Pack 4. I upgraded the memory from 1 gig to 2 gigs. It does have its original 250 gig hard drive and Wi-Fi card. This thing did come with factory installed Wi-Fi. The only thing I wish it did have was a floppy drive, but floppy drives are cheaper by the dozen nowadays. And this one, I don't know the status of it. It's not an AMD Athlon XP system. It is a Socket 478 Celeron system, because if you know, these eMachines, as well as some other counterparts, they had these Best Tech power supplies in them, and their 5-volt standbys used to go up in flames, quite literally. So this system must have been affected by that, and the motherboard must have went with it during that point. So this one got rebuilt with a Socket 478 motherboard that now has bulging capacitors. Go figure. I don't know if this system actually still works. I don't know for sure. I haven't bothered to test it because I haven't had the time and I don't have the interest. But I've kept it on my shelf because it was a free system along with the Compaq 5441. They were both free. So, There's a Gateway Solo 2000 Solo 2200 sitting on top of it. It works. I just don't know where the power supply went to it. I do have the power supply, though. This is a Pentium MMX running at 166 megahertz. LGR actually did a video on these things and how much they cost and whatnot, but this one does have the factory 48 megs of RAM, and I don't know where the hard drive went, but I do have the caddy somewhere. Anyway, this one was like $3 at a yard sale so many years ago, so yeah, but anyway, there's that. And Other than a couple other systems, and I think I'm going to have to go to the other room for this, so give me just 1 second. I think this is the only other system that I have out here, which is inside this literal mess. Quite literally a mess, but that wasn't my fault. Anyway, here we have an HP Pavilion 23 B320 all-in-one system. I don't have two of these anymore. I actually sold the other one. This one does not have a power supply with it, and it also has a 500 gig hard drive. I want to say that this is an AMD E2-2000, if I remember the specs correctly, with 6 gigs of RAM. I want to say that those are the specs, but don't quote me on that. Anyway, I might be getting rid of this thing stripped for parts, because I don't really need it. Although, if somebody has the power supply to one of these things, I'd gladly sell it to you, because I don't need it. But I could use the extra RAM in my iMac, so who knows, we'll see what happens. I might upgrade the iMac from the already plentiful 16 gigs of memory, and maybe we'll see if I can put more into it. Or I'll just throw the memory in my MacBook, we'll see, because they both take DDR3, just like that system does. Either way, there's nothing in here that's of interest, so we're going to go ahead and head inside now. So here we are inside. Of course, my room's a complete mess, so please don't comment on it. Otherwise, your comment will just be removed, and you may be blocked. Anyway, here is my recent acquisition, which I'm hoping to make a video on soon, and hopefully do some repair videos on. This is a late 2005 G5 Power Mac, and this one is actually the quad G5. I actually got lucky. This one was given to me, and this was by a client. It does need some data recovery job done on the hard drive, so I got to set up a Linux system to do that, and it's a big pain in the butt, but we'll get this thing up and running. This does have the quad 2.5 gigahertz G5 setup in it. It has its original 250 gig hard drive as well as a 500 gig, which was an addition later on, which was never used. This does have the 256 meg GeForce 6600 graphics card, and I want to say there's some other things about the system that are noteworthy, but I don't know. I think it's got like 6 gigs of RAM in it. I upgraded that from the original amount that I got it with. Now, I do have two G5s, if some of you might know now. There is my dual 2.3 gigahertz G5. This was the 99-cent G5 off eBay, and it's got no aluminum side panel. And this one does work, but it won't boot Mac OS X because of some kind of kernel panicking every time I boot a Mac OS X operating system on this. So who knows? I might end up parting this G5 out and put some of the nicer parts into the quad G5 or just whatever, because the Mac graphics cards in these are flashed with a Mac BIOS, so you can't readily put them into a PC, which is kind of annoying. The system right down here you can't really see too well, and I'm pretty sure you're not going to be able to see it too well when I review the footage, but this is a Lenovo ThinkPad T60, technically an IBM ThinkPad T60, because this was the very first ThinkPad model that was built in partnership with Lenovo and IBM branding. This one, I believe, is a 2 gigahertz Core 2 Duo with 2 gigs of RAM, which I took the memory out of. It has a broken display, and the keyboard is not much far off, so it's probably going to just get junked. I'm going to get a newer ThinkPad eventually to replace the fallen T60, because I love these things. I would like to get a T430 at a minimum, but that's just me. We'll see what ends up happening, because obviously I'm not worried about that right now, because I got the MacBook. This one here is the Dimension E510. Which I got, and this is the higher end model of the E310, essentially, even though it looks silver. They're both Pentium 4 HTs, although I suppose you could have probably got this with a Pentium D, same as the other one. This one's a 3 gigahertz Pentium 4, and I upgraded this one to 4 gigs of RAM, because it has 4 RAM slots, DDR2, and has the original 80 gig hard drive in it, and this one I believe is running Windows 7 64-bit at the moment, because I'm going to do some testing between different operating systems to see whether or not, if in basic use, you can still use a Pentium 4 in 2017. And the cool thing about this system, as a matter of fact, I'll show this to you. Please, again, mind the mess. This does have a dedicated graphics card on it, and the onboard video has a knockout plug, so you can't readily use the Intel 915 integrated video on these things. You use the PCI Express slots, although you can use the Intel 915 integrated video. Why you would, I don't know. Use the PCI Express slot. You'll have a better time than the 915. And believe me, that is with experience, because the E310 does not have the PCI Express slot. And trying to use Intel 915 video in anything other than Windows XP is a pain in the rear. A real big pain in the rear. So, yeah. 5 minutes left on the food. Woohoo! get to the desktops here in a little bit. Let's take a look at this laptop. Well, actually, I won't bother opening it. I'll save it for its own video. But this is what I call LapDerp. This is an HP Pavilion Entertainment Series DV2225NR from probably 2007. This system does work. It doesn't look the part, considering there's a screw holding the entire display assembly together. This is a freebie, and I'm surprised it even works at all. I believe this is an AMD Turion 64X2 running at 1.6 gigahertz or something like that. It has 2 gigs of RAM in it, I think, because I took the memory out of this machine because it only had 1 gig. So I took the memory out of the ThinkPad and put it in this. So now it has 2 gigs of RAM at no extra charge. The system is actually decently well equipped. It does have S-Video, VGA, the expansion port 3 expansion thing for a port replicator or docking station sort of thing at the time that HP had. Ethernet, USB, FireWire, which is just using the 4-pin connector, and an SD card slot and an express card slot. I don't think this has the remote. No, this does not have the Windows Media Center remote, unlike some of the other models of the DV2000 series. Either way, this one does work, and it works pretty well. I threw in a 160-gig hard drive and put Windows 7 on it, and it works just fine. So, this system will get its own video to show you what's wrong with it exactly, which is not just missing screws. Down below that, we have my Compaq Presario S4020WM, which is the Walmart special from 2003 that only shipped with 128 megs of RAM when it was new. So this will get a recovery partition video pretty quick. So this is one that was requested on my Discord server, which, by the way, the link is down below if you haven't joined. Permanent link, by the way. And just thought I'd let you guys know that this system does have a recovery partition, and it will get a video of me using that recovery partition here pretty quick. So, yeah. If you have not seen the video on the system, I suggest that you do. It would probably be beneficial if you do that. And the one below it is actually a custom-built system in a Cooler Master case. This is an AMD Athlon 2 X2-260. I think it's on the AM2 platform. Might be AM3. Anyway, it's an AMD Athlon 2 X2-245. Running at, I think it was like 260 runs at 3.2 gigahertz. The 245, I believe, runs at 2.9 gigahertz. It's a dual-core CPU, hence the X2. I believe this has 4 gigabytes of RAM in it. It does have onboard Radeon HD 4200 graphics, hence the HDMI output on the motherboard, which you can probably just barely see. This system was a freebie in return for some computer IT work, which was really just an install of Windows 10. So it's a decent little system. It'll certainly get its own video, not a live stream, which I previously featured the system in, which was a live stream. So it'll probably get its own video someday of me reinstalling Windows 10 back on this system. This might end up being the Media Center PC. We'll see, because it's got that onboard HDMI, which I really could benefit from. Now, I got some more laptops in here. I had to take a break and go get my food out of the oven. Junk Chromebook over there, not even going to bother mentioning it. Inside of here is my Dell Latitude D620, which I need to do a repaste job on, so I'll probably do that at some point because it needs a CPU repaste job. And by that point, I'll probably take the CPU out of the ThinkPad T60 and I'll toss it in this, so it makes this a Core 2 Duo system and a 64-bit system, so that'd be kind of nice. Upgraded from the old Core Duo T2300 and put in that nice 2 gigahertz Core 2 Duo to make the thing actually somewhat useful, even though it's stuck on an Intel 945 bus. Whatever. Might make for a decent Linux system. I might experiment with it on that. Anyway, right under here is my Toshiba Satellite Pro 410CS or something like that. And that's a 90 megahertz Pentium with 40 megabytes of memory, although it might not actually be in this bag. It might be my iBook G4, but they're both the same size. My iBook G4 is a 1.2 gigahertz G4 with 768 megs of memory, so I thought I'd point that system out. Underneath there is where my iBook G3 sits, as well as the Dell Inspiron 5100. So, all sorts of things that I could be mentioning, but, you know, the full spec list will be down below in the description, in case anybody's wondering about the specs of every single one. And now the cream de la cream of this video, or the best systems that I have, are this HP XW6600 workstation, which this is a dual quad-core Intel Xeon workstation, which technically would be, in spec-wise, more powerful than my main system, which is my mid-2011 iMac. However, this is a DDR2 ECC system, so it has 10 gigs of DDR2 ECC memory and whatnot. I'm still waiting on getting a graphics card for the system, and then it'll be back up and running as my daily Windows system, which will probably be over here amongst all the garbage. And then, of course, the mid-2011 21.5-inch iMac, which has a big smear on the screen, which I need to clean off in the worst way. Probably do that after I make this clip. Core i5-2500S, 16 gigs of RAM, Radeon HD 6770M. Nice system. Make all my videos on this thing now, and it's amazing. I love this system. Like, it took the High Sierra upgrade with ease and no issues with it, and even does dual monitor support really well. So, not too shabby. I'd like a newer one, but I'll deal with this one for now, because, of course, this was just in a trade, so. I think that's it. Other than my Dell Latitude CPI, which I didn't mention until just now, which is another one I have, I think that's pretty much it. I think that's all I got. Of course, you can read the list in the description for the full spec list of each and every single system. That way you know exactly which ones I mentioned and whatnot and what I have in my collection, including ones that I didn't mention at all, which may or may not be in the next video or after this one or whatever. So, I think that's going to be it for now to wrap this video up. So, I appreciate you guys taking time to watch, and I'll see you all in the next one. Ciao.